I met Arthur originally when I was in school. Most probably it was somewhere around 1968 or something, when I was sitting for the O-level, before the launch of the landing on the moon. And or maybe even before, because Arthur was president of the Astronomical Society and I was a member. And we used to meet once a month at the Lincoln Auditorium, which was the American Embassy's outreach program. They used to bring movies of the moon landings, or not the movies, all the Apollo, Gemini, Mercury programs, and show them, because we didn't have TV at that time. And this was the only way we could actually see it in video. And Arthur used to go for most of these launches, because he was the compere with Walter Cronkite in most of these shows. So he used to bring back and talk to us about the space race, and that motivated us into astronomy, as well as I was motivated to continue to make it my profession. I mean, maritime archaeology in this country started with the discovery of the what they call the silver reef outside the Great Basins. And that was a discovery by, actually Arthur was writing a book at the time called Indian Ocean Adventure. And while he was writing the book, Mike Wilson and Rodney Donkles were filming in the Great Basins. And they come across this wreck with a whole lot of silver coins. And they are brought back. I presume Arthur also went diving after that. And that really was the first time the real maritime archaeology started in this country. Over the years, I sort of got interested very much in coins. And so these coins were also part of my interest, even though there were the coins that were found there were Indian Surat rupees, bundled up into bags of 1,000, which had frozen solid over the years in underwater. And there were lumps of 1,000 weighing about 25 pounds each. There's a date of 1311, which is dated to 1702. So there's a brand new bag. Most of the coins actually are of that year. There are a couple of half rupees and a couple of coins of the adjoining years, which means that there was at least one or two bags which were mixed and not from the mint, and I have some of them. This is a lump that I have found obtained in Sri Lanka from a part of that wreck. The original would have been a very big lump, about 1,000 coins. This must be having about 20 years. So when the tsunami happened, there was a trip down to afterwards to Unawatuna, where I can still remember Arthur just refused to get down there. For two reasons. One, it was the place that he loved the most, and it was in shambles. It was also the fact that Unawatuna has ceased to be what he liked about it, you know, that deserted, beautiful bay. Maybe he's guilty to a certain extent of making it so popular and destroying the beauty of that bay. So for my wedding, Arthur was one of the signatories for my wedding in 1979. And what embarrassed me mostly was that I was in bow tie and Arthur was in national dress. I got so embarrassed at that time when he was in beautiful white national dress. And so that motivated me in about 2-3 years to decide that I'll never wear a suit or tie ever in my life. And from about 1982, I never worn a suit or a tie. Arthur was very scientific, and I think one of the strictest science fiction writers, where, you know, anything that contradicted science, he didn't like. And he was a stickler for absolute creativity. When he was making 2001 Space Odyssey, I can remember him telling he was very worried about the scene where Bowman comes back into the mothership, because if you get exposed into vacuum, your blood will boil. So he actually did a lot of research and discovered that your blood will not boil for about 30 seconds because of the impedance of it. It's not on the surface, right? So it takes some time for the signal to go down to boil the blood. So he made sure that that scene did not take longer than 30 seconds because he wanted to be accurate with respect to that, him surviving 30 seconds of vacuum.